restaurant.
Hurry up now, it's gonna be cold.
Top French chefs.
It looks fucking brilliant.
Oh, fucking hell. Fucking hell.
The finest ingredients.
That is incredible.
Food fit for a king.
Is that all for me?
La Riviera in Inverness seems to have it all.
Yeah, all done.
There's just one thing missing. Customers. Without them, you don't stand a chance. And I should know. 2 years ago, I had to close my own restaurant in Scotland.
I'm just worried that you don't fall into the same fucking trap that I did, and I lost a lot of money.
This week, Kitchen Nightmares gets personal.
It's been the biggest wake-up call in my entire life.
Scotland, home of the brave. Home, too, of haggis, neeps and tatties. And the deep-fried Mars bar. But in Inverness, there's a restaurant on a mission to bring sophisticated French cooking to my fellow countrymen.
OK, you send me 2 prestata right now, please.
Yes.
It's the vision of French head chef Loïc Lefebvre, who's trained in some of the best kitchens in France.
I went to work for the president in France, Mr. Chirac. When we had, like, Mr. Bush is coming, or Japanese president is coming, used to do, like, big function.
Service, 1 sea bass, 1 brim, table 14, go.
Then I moved to work with the Purcell brothers in Montpellier, and they are 3 Michelin stars.
Service, please.
I can't wait to meet a young chef with such an impressive pedigree.
Hello, Loïc.
Gordon Ramsay. Nice to meet you.
Enchanté.
Enchanté.
And this is the team?
Yeah.
To help realise his dream, Loïc's handpicked an impeccably trained brigade. Sous-chef yes. Jeffrey has worked in restaurants with both 1 and 2 Michelin stars.
Did you work with Loïc in France?
No.
No.
I came basically here because it's a very good opportunity to work with some of the 3 Michelin stars.
Regis also has a Michelin star studied background.
Sorry.
How long have you been cooking?
8 years in France and in a different country, you know.
And so does the junior of the team, Nicola.
And Nicola, whereabouts in France are you from?
Britain.
Brittany?
Nantes.
Got a good football team there, huh?
Yeah.
But now you support Celtic or Rangers?
FC Nantes.
FC Nantes.
Oh,
I see. Hey, you're in Inverness, for God's sake. You've got to support a proper team.
And Gerard's not letting the side down either. His previous jobs were at Michelin star level as well.
Gerard, do you have a Scottish girlfriend?
Yes, my French accent. It's a good point.
1,400 miles from the French Riviera, Loïc has created a mini French stronghold in Inverness.
And no one's Scottish in the kitchen?
No, no Scottish.
No Scottish?
There was some, but not anymore.
Did you sack them?
No. First time when I came in the kitchen, I switched off the microwave, put it in a car park, and 3 days after, I was by myself.
They got the message?
Yeah, because they were using microwave all the time.
Oh, God.
Powder for stock. Deep frying everything, even fondant potatoes. So I had to build a new team,
good.
Which is good.
Loïc's determined that his dream team is going to get him his very own Michelin star.
A bit like Roman Abramovich when he wanted to get the Premiership title. Yeah. He went round and got the best manager, the best football players, and then brought them all over to Chelsea.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Off family pump, that's good.
Yeah,
all done.
I think if you can get a Michelin star, that should be great for us.
We are looking to achieve like 1 Michelin star to start with. Why not 2? And you know,
this is new.
Even the fridge is top of the league.
It's wow. A big walking fridge.
Fucking hell, look at the size of it. Yeah. It's like a 1-bedroom flat.
Yeah.
And the produce is the very best. Flying vegetables in from France is over the top, even for me. But the local shellfish is really top notch.
They are amazing.
Fish on Sky.
When they come down to London, they're definitely not that fresh, I can assure you. That is incredible.
Fuck me. They've got the best of everything here. I mean, really the best of everything. Someone must be paying a small fucking fortune to run this place.
And that someone is multimillionaire Barry Larson, hot from his 600-acre private shooting estate. He made his fortune from the catering business, but it wasn't exactly fine dining.
Morning, Julie, how are you?
This is the man who brought Kentucky Fried Chicken, Wimpy and Harry Ramsden's to Scotland.
All right, we'll see you in a minute.
And now he's invested nearly £2 million trying to prove he can make fine dining finger-licking good.
Sounds amazing.
the sort of dream team that you've put together.
Yeah.
Slightly concerned about the expense involved in that, because dream teams don't come cheap.
No, they don't.
You haven't got any grey hair.
So yeah, I've got some. Yeah.
Well, you're hiding it very well. Unless you die the fucking thing.
No, I don't die. Not yet. but no, it's expensive. You know what the school is.
Yeah, big time. Have you owned hotels?
No, I haven't owned before. I haven't owned hotels before. We've had various restaurants, fast food chains that we've built up, sold out.
Really?
Family restaurants that we still run. But obviously at a different, completely different level.
I mean, a fast food restaurant's miles away from anything to do with fine dining.
Yeah, but, you know, you still want to produce quality for the spend.
It sounds fantastic, but this place is costing Barry over £8,000 a week on food and staff costs alone. And they seem to have forgotten the three most important things in the restaurant business. Customers, customers, customers. 4 days a week, the restaurant's dead. And every night it's empty, it's another big dent in Barry's investment and Luik's ego.
Sometimes you get zero.
Really?
Yeah.
Must be hard that when it's zero, no?
Yeah.
Especially with all these team here.
It's a nightmare for us.
Does it hurt?
Yeah, a bit, yeah.
You've got the team, but you want to play. You're ready to go. But...
Oh, yeah.
That's difficult.
We are like dogs, you know, when they go shooting.
Yeah.
We are ready.
Luik's hungry for success, but the locals aren't biting.
Can you do me a favour? Can you read that out for me?
Oh, gosh, I can't say that. What, Bollinger of Jerusalem artichoke?
Do you know what that is?
One glance at his menu, and I think I've spotted the problem before I've even tasted the food.
Not sure.
Declinization salmon.
Baragoulis just...
That sounds good.
How's your goulis?
Yeah.
Baragoulis.
That doesn't sound very appetising.
Well, no, I'd probably order that one.
What do you think that means?
This food may appeal to the connoisseurs in the south of France.
I haven't got the focus.
But this is Scotland's smallest city.
Right, yeah. Would you eat that?
Would I eat it?
Aye.
You can't read it, so you don't know what it is.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Barry and Luik want Michelin-level success, but I'm afraid they've lost sight of the basics.
You are an impatient bastard.
Yeah.
You want it, and you want to get your shopping trolley and go along and get that and get that, and you know, I can see it in your eyes. You've had a lot of success beforehand, bringing all these things in together.
Yeah.
It's not the perfect recipe for an instant hit.
Right.
I'm just worried that you don't fall into the same fucking trap that I did, and I lost a lot of money.
Right.
It was a proud day for me when I opened Amaryllis in my hometown, Glasgow. We got off to a great start, and within our first year, we'd won a Michelin star. But as the menu became more elaborate, the diners started to dwindle. The food was so fancy, it put off the locals. They stopped coming, and I was forced to close Amaryllis down.
It's a bit of a deja vu for me, and I'm concerned that you may be running too quickly, too soon. You know, you're in danger. Oh, fuck it.
It's going too far.
That happened to me after 12 years at the top.
I saw, sir.
There's no doubt in Luik's talent. It's his lack of experience that worries me.
One scallop, level three.
It's his first ever head chef's job. There's always a big, big trap they fall in.
Are we finished?
Where they try to do too much too soon and almost try to be sort of competitive and thinking that what they saw in their previous kitchen, which was in a three Michelin star, I've got to be better than that. And that's where a lot of young chefs fail.
Could you check table 10 for me, please?
You put the name and everything, huh?
It's my second day at La Riviera, a top restaurant with no customers. So if the locals aren't eating here, where are they eating?
Busy for lunch. Fuck me, £5.95 for two courses, starter and main.
Inverness is a fast-growing city, and the restaurant market is clearly thriving.
£7.95 is fucking cheap, isn't it? Now, look, early supper menu, two courses, £9.95.
I've asked Luik to serve me dinner from his a la carte menu, which costs £34 for two courses.
Yeah. With that team in there and the produce in the fridge, it's to die for. So it should be a great dinner. I'm looking forward to this one.
One scallop to follow one duck. The breast pink.
Yes, yes.
Allez, let's go.
This is your canapé. You have an olive medallion and a cheese beignet.
Canapés and a pre-starter. This is ambitious food for London, let alone Inverness.
Potato soup with wasabi.
Very creamy. Very, very rich. I'm excited about the food, but I don't feel comfortable sat here.
You're like a painter. You need a good eye. You know, like the painter will put something like black here and not here, because for him it doesn't look right.
Okay, let's go. One scallops, table 9.
Very complicated. A lot of combinations of flavors going on.
For me, the golden rule is always keep it simple.
You're tasting a broad bean and white asparagus and a citrus vinaigrette, a confit tomato, fennel seeds, fennel flowers, chervil, salad, parmesan. There must be 20 things going on this plate. And then, you know, that looks fantastic. But didn't do anything really.
Next up, duck on deux service.
This is a duck leg. Decided to make it a ravioli on duck leg, table 9.
A good 10 to 12 flavors on the plate again. It's just confusion. And your mind is sort of working overtime to try and understand what's happening.
Okay, service please.
A main course served in two parts. That's just pretentious.
Almost like someone is uncontrollable and almost like a little bit carried away and overexcited and nothing saying, just stop, come back. Ooh la la. Is that all for me?
Yes, it's all for
me. Luig seems desperate to impress. Next, he'll be telling me how to eat it.
If I may, to recommend you the order, you've got the tiramisu first, please, then the floating island, then you'll have the souffle, then the sorbet, finally the cornetto with marmalade.
Yeah, what a load of bollocks. Next, we'll be told which adaptation to pee in because of the fucking salmon in the river.
Technically, flavours were amazing. The scallops were delicious. The light vinaigrette. Did it need the parmesan? Did it need the flowers? And do you need that many flavors to make it work?
I won't change anything on the flavor. I think the way we work, the product, bring to the guest the flavors that I want.
Your personality has to be comfortable on the plate. And I see a lot of uneasiness on the plate. I don't know if you're confident enough in what you're doing. And I've got to be very honest because this is very crucial. But this has to work. Barry, what do you think?
When you think about it, it's probably right that he has to just find his own style.
Barry's acting more like a besotted sugar daddy than Luick's boss.
You take on somebody like that and you're taking them on because of their capabilities and their ambition. And, you know, the last thing I want to try and do is restrain that ambition and what he's doing. I'm not, you know, I'm not a chef and I couldn't do what he does. I'm not really in a position to criticise.
One sea bass, one grill.
But I am. This place isn't even breaking even. And yet Barry's forking out $4,500 a week just on staff.
Allez, service.
It's no way to run a successful business.
Barry's in love with you.
No, you're not too.
No, he's in love with your food.
Yeah, I think you like it, yeah.
He's never going to be your critic. And what I've got to understand is where is your critic coming from? Who's telling you to stop? That's it. Send it.
When I think it's all right, don't touch it anymore.
Goes.
No wonder his food's over the top. Now I want to see how he runs his kitchen.
Scalpel.
Tweezers.
Forceps.
As every plate journeys around the kitchen, each of his seven chefs adds another flourish. And all this unnecessary fussing is wasting time and money.
Hurry up now. Yeah, all done.
There's so many hands that are going on round the kitchen. The plate, is that normal for it to go round? Can they not finish anything?
They need my sauce. It's the same for the lobster, they need my sauce. Okay. You put the plate under the grill and I sauce, okay?
Service, please. Service.
Up. One is missing. No, it's okay, sorry.
Okay. Yes. Fucking hell, it feels like we've done 250. And all we've cooked in the last 2.5 hours is 10.
Service, please.
I felt that I wanted to just say stop. What you've got at the beginning was just enough for me.
We prefer something more simple.
Simple because the ingredients you've got are phenomenal.
He needs to let his food speak for itself. his approach feels outdated and pretentious.
Is it easier if we maybe cook a dish, like cook the scallops and look at the difference and go through it together that way? Right, now what should we do? Scallops?
Now?
Whatever.
I've got a few things to do first.
Okay.
For the guests tonight, and I'll be with you.
Okay. If the restaurant was full, I could understand his arrogance. But it's hemorrhaging cash, and no one seems to care.
It's almost like the barricades are up and, you know, nothing's going to get through, because all I want to do is do the dish together and look at the different stages we're taking out to make it more appealing. But it doesn't seem to sort of sink in. I only want to be part of the team. Just let me in. Being hard ass is, you know, nice, but when you're in this situation with over-complex food and no direction, I'd fucking grab that kind of insight if I was in his shoes.
The owner, trust me completely. I can do what I want, whatever I want. So it was a deal between us. Carte blanche on whatever I do.
Luke's behaving like a spoiled brat. So as a last resort, I'll try his brigade.
Is there something you can, you know, work closely with Luke? Yeah?
Cannot make the food too complex. You can help us as well, I'm sure.
I want to help. Yeah. Definitely. Let me fucking in. Yes?
First, I'm going to tackle the language barrier.
I'm going to have to get you speaking fluent Scottish. Datty wee bastard.
Datty wee bastard.
No, too far.
Datty wee bastard.
It's getting there. Datty wee bastard.
Sorry?
It's fluent in Scottish now.
All right.
So when someone upsets him in the high street...
Datty wee bastard. Or piss off.
Or piss off. No, piss off.
Piss off out of my way.
Oh, fucking hell.
fucking hell, yeah.
I'm making headway with the team, and perhaps I can get through to Luik if we're on neutral ground.
Are you familiar with any of the songs? Do you know what they sing here? I wouldn't shout that here if I was you.
I'm not sure the locals will appreciate French football songs any more than they'll appreciate Luik's food.
I look at your situation and I can't stop comparing it to my situation when I opened up in my hometown in Glasgow. It got too serious. And then everybody was scared to come. And then we lost a lot of money. And, you know, what's the point in keeping a restaurant open if you're losing money? Yeah. And it broke my heart. And that was my hometown. I was born there. And that's what, you know, I don't want to see happen with you. Yeah. You're running the Riviera, like a three Michelin star establishment. You started at such a high level.
I don't know if it is such a high level. I mean, when you practice with, I mean, like your chefs, when they practice with you, one day they'll go by their own. What do you think they're going to do?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Chips and fish.
I know, but you've got to start with the locals. It's not going to survive unless that restaurant's full.
So what do the locals want?
Some mustard or ketchup?
Mustard, please.
Thank you. You have to help yourself, you lazy bastard.
Thank you.
You can't beat an Aberdeen Angus steak sandwich.
That's not bad, though, is it?
That's not bad. Oh, beef is good, huh?
And when you've got such good local produce, you don't need to mess with it.
He didn't give me my change back, did he?
I don't.
No. See, he's really Scottish.
It's already my third day, but nothing's sinking in. Surely Luik can't ignore the evidence if it's staring him in the face. This isn't a meal for six. All this is dinner for one at La Riviera.
Looks like a fucking feast for a king. Henry VIII. It's quite interesting when you start from one end and go all the way right to the very end. It helps you to identify where you can just draw back a little bit. Mm-hmm. And look at the whole balance of exactly what you're doing.
And people have to understand that they are here to enjoy it. Mm. So they have to spend a bit more of time on the table, like just say, okay, we've got 2.5 hours to enjoy it.
I couldn't eat all that. Mm-hmm. I'd have to stop halfway, I think. I'd stop halfway. Yes?
I don't know. If I was not able to eat all this, I wouldn't do it.
What Luik can't get into his stubborn French brain is that refusing to trust his ingredients isn't just putting off his customers. It's also a turn-off for Michelin inspectors. Maybe I can convince Barry. It is his money, after all.
Recommend me a whiskey.
I'll try to explain in terms that any hot-blooded Scotsman will understand.
And one for Barry, please, because yes, obviously Barry's paying, so... Can I just have a touch of ice in there, please?
Shit.
Yeah, thank you. Do I have a touch of soda in there, please?
No, because you're going to spoil the complicated the drinks.
Are you suggesting or telling me?
Doing both. And no way soda on the malt whiskies. There's no way. No.
Let me just say something. You're absolutely right. You don't fuck with things that are good. And the first thing I said to Livick about the food, when you've got quality ingredients, let them speak for themselves. And when you've got something as good as that, that speaks volumes, doesn't need anything else. No fucking parsley, no chervil, no bailiff, no fucking fruit garden, nothing. Just bang, get it out. Do you understand?
Yeah, I do.
Barry seems to be getting it, and I've got an idea that just might convince his chef.
The Saint-Jacques dish. I want you to cook that, and I'm going to cook a Saint-Jacques dish alongside you.
There's a lot of way to do it, I mean, like...
Yeah, of course. It's just I'm 38, I'm 10 years older than you, and so it's not because I'm fucking 10 times better than you. I just want to make you understand how I think.
Yeah?
OK. OK, Monterey.
What Lewick doesn't know is that I've invited ex-AA inspector David Young to judge the dishes for himself. And what he won't know is whose is whose. My Saint-Jacques dish has just four simple ingredients. As well as the scallops, it has a cauliflower puree and a caper and raisin dressing.
How long for you?
30 seconds.
Lewick's dish has at least 14 different flavours.
So you've got the new season asparagus, white asparagus, with the roasted scallops. You've got a fennel artichoke and anise jus. And I mix it with the fennel milk, OK? You've got the Parmesan crisps, and you've got the broom.
Thank you, Dad.
It's time to let Lewick into my little secret.
I've arranged for the inspector, the AA guy, to come and taste our food. Thank you. Go, darling, please.
So they're going to make, like, a competition.
Go, darling.
Food inspectors are feared and revered by chefs all over the country. If they judge your food worthy of Michelin stars or AA rosettes, the reward is a place on the gastronomic map.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thanks.
And ideally, customers beating a path to your door.
Thank you.
Will he prefer Lewick's elaborate plateful or my simpler rendition?
This particular one has much more visual impact. I get the feeling that the dish is going to taste of exactly what was described to me. Whereas this one looks a little bit over-garnished. There's a bit of a muddle of different types of flavours.
Inspectors like David can make or break a restaurant's reputation.
Introduce you to Lewick.
Nice to meet you.
If Lewick is going to gain a coveted Michelin star, his food really needs to be worthy of four rosettes.
How difficult, David, is it to get four AA rosettes?
Well, it's very difficult because, to put it into context, as at this moment, there are only two AA four rosette restaurants in Scotland.
In the whole of Scotland?
In the whole of Scotland.
Is it a four-star dish, what you've eaten?
This one, Gordon?
Yes.
No. No, this particular dish would be somewhere between two and three rosettes, whereas this dish would be probably four rosettes. Mm-hmm. The combination of the cauliflower and caper puree just absolutely lifted the dish into a different dimension. Whereas this one, some of the flavours were overcomplicated, to be frank about it. And it may be just a case of sometimes less is actually more.
Lewick has taken the news badly.
Ne m'abandonne pas.
He thinks I've stitched him up. Anglo-French relations have hit an all-time low. But time is running out at the Riviera.
It's got to work, hasn't it? It's your first head chef job. You can't afford to fuck that.
Will I ever make princes out of this colony of frogs?
Smile! Yes. Fucking hell, it doesn't cost anything in Scotland.
I'm getting towards the end of my week at La Riviera, and I don't know if Lewick is still speaking to me. Last night he reacted badly when an AA inspector confirmed that his food was over fussy.
What was the first thing you thought about this morning after yesterday with the inspector? What was the one message you learned from it?
Now, I had your advice, I had his advice as well. So, one, you can say maybe he's wrong. Mm-hmm. Two, you start to take care of that thing and maybe I am wrong. Mm-hmm. So...
It's a difficult thing to accept.
The French franc has finally dropped. It's been hard for Louis, but he's already changing his game plan. He's come up with a new, much simpler idea for the scallop dish.
It looks fucking brilliant. Uh-huh. And what I can identify now, I know there's apple because you kept the green on there, I know there's rocket, I know there's pumpkin seed, and it makes me feel comfortable because I know what I'm about to eat.
Yeah.
I can identify what you're doing. That's delicious. Everything that goes on the plate has to have a reason. Yeah. Not for this, but for here.
For the palate.
Yeah, for the palate. And what you've just done there, Louis, you've given your food clear insight.
Okay. You understand?
It's not three, four, five rosette for me. I'd be happy eating that anywhere, you know that.
Mm.
Where's that fucking inspector? Putain. Fucking hell. Hallelujah. I've just taken fucking France.
Now Louis has finally swallowed his pride, we can begin to move forward. With his team behind him, maybe he has a chance of achieving his ultimate goal.
You told me that you wanted a Michelin star. And at first, I didn't think that was possible, you know that, because of how things got so complicated. But with this here, there's no two ways about it. It's definitely worth a star. I respect Louis for taking it on board,
yeah.
Because it's a fucking hard lesson.
Yeah.
Very hard lesson, but, you know, it's got to work, hasn't it? It's your first head chef job.
Mm.
You can't afford to fuck that.
Yeah.
Crucial. You've got the right training. Now you've got the perfect position to do it.
Mm.
But winning over the kitchen is only half the battle. Carolyn is the maitre d', and she's also Louis's girlfriend. She's responsible for writing the elaborate menus, and have already discovered that the locals haven't got a clue what they mean. It's time to turn the tables.
Read that for me.
Crunching pepperhead with mashed tatties.
Nice. Dirty wee bastard.
To prove a point, I've given them a menu of classic Scottish dishes.
What do you think it is? Something sexy? Something spicy? Tatties.
Tatties.
Luke, what do you think that one is there? This one here.
Bread is for far. And we talk about in salad of grilled. No idea at all.
What is Queen Mary tart?
Queen Mary tart.
Queen Mary tart. Yeah.
And
whipped Canadian
cream. Ah no, crumble crunch.
Do you have any idea what I'm trying to say?
It's impossible to choose anything you don't understand.
Exactly. That's exactly
it's
what it
difficult
is.
Difficult for make a choice when you have this one because it's.
Yes, that's.
You know?
It's difficult for fucking Scotland to understand
okay,
you guys.
Yeah,
that's what I'm trying
know,
to say.
Same. Yeah, he's same. Yes.
So it's less intimidating if you have an assortment of salmon, you know, a selection of mandarin. Do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Yeah. At last, I'm getting somewhere.
Okay. Just look at what you're taking to the table. And. Fucking hell. You know, it's like you're a librarian.
Yep.
You should see what it's like when the table are sat and six of them are looking in here.
Yep.
You've lost everybody.
Yeah.
There's no dinner anymore because everyone's behind a brick wall.
Yep.
You can simplify the whole thing.
Yep.
Just one beautiful open card, starters, mains.
Yep.
So everything going down there has simplified it.
And it's not just the menus that need lightening up.
Smile, mon ami. Smile. He's far better looking when he's smiling.
Ah,
smile! Fucking hell, it doesn't cost anything in Scotland.
Well tried.
Well tried, yeah. Oh, fucking hell, throw him in the river. We're supposed to be in a restaurant, not a Sunday school church service. Where's my Bible?
Barry's grasped the nettle and has radical plans to transform the dining room.
I'm going to take this column away.
Yep.
I'm going to take the raised area away at the back on that side. So we've got
at a cost of £35,000.
The arches over the doors we're going to square off.
Yeah.
And then it's all panelled all the way around. Some nice artwork.
It doesn't look that bad, does it?
And it doesn't look... I don't think it looks particularly...
Yeah, it's not glamorous, but it's not shitty.
It's just not... I just think it doesn't look right.
But I've got a low-cost idea, which I think will give La Riviera a unique selling point.
I said less salad.
I'd like you to start thinking about having a table in the kitchen where you have locals to come and sit and eat.
Yeah.
It starts to break up the sort of wall that, you know, sometimes you have when you come to a strange new country. As I've discovered, having a chef table in the kitchen is a great way to bring customers into your world and keeping the chefs on their toes. And this would be the first restaurant in Scotland to have one.
I think this would be the best place.
Yep,
this
is down
definitely
there.
Yeah, just in a corner, and they will see
everything.
Yeah.
And it can help create something exciting in Inverness. Can you imagine the buzz going around town? The chef's table could be a way of showing off and establishing your reputation here, and be first.
Yeah, I think it's an exciting idea.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
I mean, for once, we're going to see how do the people
react to your food.
Yeah. If it's no good, I mean, like, just to throw it.
Yeah.
Have to take care about this.
Hopefully they won't do that. Super.
But it all costs money. And although the chef table is a great investment, until they've got customers coming in, they need to make economies elsewhere.
Crab, foie gras, and hand-dived scallops, which are king scallops. So, I mean, the Rolls Royce of ingredients. I mean, everything's here. Fucking hell.
Luick needs to do what I did when I started out. Learn to use good, cheap cuts to put together an inspiring menu.
Do you ever use the shin, Luigi?
No.
Ox tongue.
Making something exquisite from a shin of beef or an ox tongue takes a lot of skill.
And the size of my feet.
And it's a great way to identify talent.
Right. Oxtail. You and you, Bridges. A little competition. I want you to cook a dish, come up with something really exciting, and then Luick and myself will look at it, and the most tastiest, delicious dish will put on a lunch menu. And for me, the most important thing about this is always a sign of a very, very good cook to turn something very, very cheap into something quite special. So, Bridges, take it to bed and think about it.
Next morning, I'm pleased to see the young chefs have taken their oxtail challenge seriously.
Pasta?
Yes.
And
poultry, yeah.
And so it's very, you know?
Yep, nice and long.
Very wrong.
Yep.
Yep, roll it, put it back into oxtail shape from the beginning.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. Juice reduction.
Mm-hmm.
Reduction
glass.
Like a font.
The oxtail dishes for the lunch menu are almost ready, and they've each cost about a quid to put together.
So this is braised oxtail with winter vegetable, braised gem lettuce.
Dishes like these are not only highly profitable, but bringing together great Scottish produce with French flair is a winning formula.
I like the jus and just a bit of Australian honey.
Yes, it tastes delicious. With the white root vegetables, it made it feel earthy and together.
Okay.
Yeah. Who's next?
And despite what Luick thinks, simplifying his dishes will actually make them more likely to win awards.
I've never had oxtail and sesame seed together before.
Michelin inspectors never reveal their criteria, but I know from experience that beautifully cooked food is not enough.
Next.
Inspectors look for good quality ingredients, ideally regional and definitely in season.
And I put carrots, celeriac.
This idea is great.
And the balance of flavours is crucial.
Very rich.
It needs a salad.
Yeah,
because it's quite rich.
And what I like is you put the salad just next to and not on a plate like this. You can choose.
Thank you.
But first and foremost, don't confuse a Michelin inspector's palate by putting too many ingredients on the plate.
Never expected anyone French to come up with a jacket potato stuffed. Thank you.
The simpler, the better.
What do you think?
Brilliant idea.
Mm-hmm. Flavors are very good. What you've managed to do is to bring out the true flavor of oxtail. Above all.
Thank you.
Okay, Mel Gibson.
Any one of these dishes would be worthy of a place on the lunch menu. But we're choosing just one. I want to see if Luik and I will agree on the winner.
I'm going to touch my plate, which I'd like on the lunch menu, uh-huh. And you touch the plate after three. Yeah?
Okay.
One, two, three.
Equal.
Oh. Well done. Hey, well done.
Let's go. It was real and authentic Scottish food.
Yep.
That's, I think he understood, really understood where we want to go.
With Luik leading the way, we're ready to relaunch the restaurant.
For me, it's a critical stage for any restaurant is to get a lunch full.
And if our customers have an enjoyable lunch, chances are they'll be back for a more expensive a la carte dinner.
And when they leave with a bloody good lunch, good prices, I can guarantee, by the time 5 o'clock in the afternoon hits, you know, they've told 100 people, go there for dinner because I had a fantastic lunch. I want to see if we can push this starter, main and dessert, 1 hour.
Yeah. As well as the new oxtail dish, the menu will include mackerel, pheasant and goat cheese ravioli, venison from Barry's estate, tuna and the cheapest cut of pork.
Customers sometimes are scared about belly of pork, thinking fat, greasy. We've taken the fat off, rolled it, spiced on a bed of spinach. It's a caramelised onion puree. Have a taste if you wish.
And I've got some other ideas to give Scottish traditional dishes a modern twist.
This is a soup that doesn't look pretty, but tastes amazing. They wouldn't expect the Frenchman to make a cookie soup, which is a really nice way of putting your identification on it. Louis, just an idea for the rice pudding.
Yeah.
And we grew up with this kind of food, so we can go a little bit further, caramelise pineapple, mango, or even marinate the prunes in a nice malt whiskey.
Yeah.
Yeah?
The kitchen's finally turning out the kind of food that I know will definitely appeal to the locals. And even the waiters have promised to try and smile. But there's one more thing to complete the transformation.
You've got to come with me now, because we're going to become even more Scottish. Any ideas yet? Bridges, have you ever taken your knickers off before?
No.
No. Chance to show English your Scotch eggs.
Okay.
It's time for Luik and his small colony of French comrades to surrender themselves to the Scots.
Fucking hell. The things I'll do to get the arrogant French to become a little bit more Scottish is amazing. You know that? It's corn!
How do you put it on?
We don't wear pants underneath our belts.
That's wonderful. Very hot. And it's very sexy.
Attendez. Hey, there's 25 very important guests coming for lunch. Yes? But some really good news. Uh-huh. They're all women.
Nice.
Very powerful women.
Super.
If they can impress 25 influential local businesswomen, they'll be the talk of the town.
Do you guys have the oxtail on this?
Yes.
Double two, four guests. One potato soup, vegetarian. Three oxtail, two for one gnocchi. Two venison, one tuna.
Nicolas, oui, you're going to start giving them two feet. Okay? Regis, I want two mackerel, two ravioli, one oxtail, okay?
Watch your legs. Watch your frog's legs. Legs, please.
At last, Luik's team are beginning to dance to a different tune.
Two ravioli, one mackerel. Two ravioli, that's the first one. Go. Mushroom. Start. Okay, move.
The food looks really good, clear and simple.
Fucking fast. And everyone's coping really, really well. But it's the first time I've actually seen a real taste of Scotland in this kitchen. About fucking time.
Just after this, you have to go for two four.
Luik's on his way to the top of the Premier League.
Allez, go.
It's wonderfully presented. It's gorgeous. Yeah.
And judging by the reaction of his fans, he's definitely scored.
Absolutely divine. Just perfect. Absolutely perfect.
Beautiful presentation. You couldn't fault anything, really.
I would imagine normally this sort of food, you'd be talking at least a couple of hours for lunch, but to get something like this in that time scale, brilliant. It's beautiful.
You have tried
you win this. And also, okay, it's for you a present.
Thank you.
Excuse me. What the fuck is that? Who is that?
I think it's a big chef.
And what is that there?
Balls.
Balls, yeah. Trust me, I have a big pair of bollocks. Ali Le Bleu.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Chin chin.
Chin.
Louis and his team have come a long way this week. And if he sticks to my keep it simple mantra, then I think La Riviera might be on the right track for a Michelin star.
Outside. Just for the ladies, Regis, to understand that you really are part of Scotland now, we're all going to turn around. Turn around, turn around, turn around. Ready? One, two, three, go!
Right, Louis.
It's been 2 months since I was at La Riviera.
Bonjour.
Have you missed me?
Oh, a little bit, yeah.
So, what's changed?
Okay, you take one pork, one ravioli, table four.
The menu looks lovely. And you've got cheaper ingredients on? Ox cheek for the lunch menu?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I'm dying to taste the pork cheese. Can you cook me one, please?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, with the risotto.
Yeah.
It looks lovely.
Oh, yes, very nice.
That looks interesting. Is that the chef's table?
Yes, I'm finishing the chef's table.
Very impressed with that. That looks great.
Yeah.
It's good to see he's acted on my advice. But the proof of the pudding is in the eating.
Here we are, monsieur.
Thank you, Louis.
The pork cheek, which is Ebly risotto and chanterelle.
A dish with just four ingredients?
Absolutely delicious. That, for me, so far, is one of the most tasty dishes I've ever eaten here. Really, really delicious. If you continue like this, this place is only going to just get busier and busier and busier.
That's what we want.
That's a great dish to be proud of.
Thank you.
How's the refurb been going on in the dining room?
Dining room is finished for 1 week now.
Wow. Fuck me, what a difference.
Bloody hell. It looks a lot more slick, smart.
Barry must have spent a fortune on it.
Beautiful, dark panel wood, a completely different dining room.
It is another restaurant.
It feels more relaxed, but is it money well spent?
Has anything improved since the last time I was here?
Yeah, the restaurant's bookings have improved. We've just, you know, looked at what you told us on simplifying the menu, writing the menu.
Michelin star?
I would love to get one. But what's more important for me at the moment is that we build the customers.
It's certainly come a long way from the restaurant I found 2 months ago.
Yeah, all done!
His food was so elaborate.
Let's go.
There must be 20 things going on this plate.
It had frightened off the customers.
Oh, fuck it.
Fucking hell.
Hurry up now.
He was desperate for a Michelin star, but reluctant to let me help. But by the end of the week...
Bridges, take it to bed and think about it.
The message had sunk in.
Hallelujah. I've just taken fucking France.
And we were able to fill the stuffy restaurant with happy diners. His dream was to win awards. And with his newly simplified food, I thought Louis was finally producing dishes worthy of a Michelin star.
It looks fucking brilliant. Where's that fucking inspector? Putain.
This time round, I raised the bar even higher, with another surprise visitor for Louis.
Last time I saw this man, he actually gave me 3 Michelin stars, so perhaps the most revered and feared critic in the world.
Derek Brown is the grand fromage of restaurant inspectors.
Hi, Derek.
He's the ex-president of the Michelin Guide, and he's agreed to do me a favour.
I'm not going to say too much about this particular restaurant, but he's a very intriguing, talented individual, and just would love to see... what you think.
What he's capable of doing.
Yeah. Now, remember, you don't know me.
Don't know your top secret.
Sure.
Head chef Louis has no idea he has such an influential critic in his restaurant.
Won't ask if you've been through the...
For his sake, I hope Derek goes for the simple pork cheek I had.
The lamb, please.
The lamb. Mm.
Damn.
How would you like it cooked, sir?
Pink, please.
Pink?
Yeah. To me, the Scottish lamb with stuffed baby artichokes looks just as elaborate as it did 2 months ago.
I see you've got your herb garden back.
I'm from the south of France, so herbs is very important for me.
I hope to God I'm wrong.
You can't eat it.
Got
see Louis' face when he realizes that the food he's sending out now is for the ex-president of Michelin. He's gonna shit his French knickers.
Time for the moment of truth.
Louis, 2 seconds, s'il vous
plaît. Louis, do you know this gentleman? No?
No.
Sorry, Mr. Derek Brown, Louis.
I think I've seen you, yeah, already.
Yes, maybe in France somewhere. I'm dying to find out, I'm sure Louis as well. How was lunch?
Well, it was very interesting. Your technique, you've been very careful about the whole preparation of each of your dishes. But, you know, it was too complicated. There were 10 different flavours on the plate. Mm-hmm. There was garlic and herbs in the artichoke, which is itself a delicate thing. A little bit overpowering, I thought. The shoulder, which you'd done a confit of, that was the tastiest part of the dish.
The million-dollar question. Was lunch worthy of a Michelin star?
I would say that you have not got very far to go. I never gave advice in my working life before, but if you want me to give you some advice, I would simplify what you're doing. Mm-hmm. Make sure that the customers are going to be happy with every dish that you ever make them. And things like stars from the Michelin Guide will follow. Mm-hmm. The old boys have got to be replaced, so it's up to you, and you've got the talent. Just use it and refine it. Mm-hmm.
But has the message really sunk in? Or is he still intent on forcing over-elaborate French food on the locals?
This is our challenge. This is not to bring people like you do in London. Mm. The challenge is to teach them and to bring them in.
Yeah, yeah.
That's why you have to make something really special.
Yeah. Fuck me. I mean, my frustrating thing is that you've really got to understand the message because, you know, I fucking said this from day one and I'm not an inspector, I'm a chef and I see it from your level.
Service! Le rouge en urgence.
Will he ever understand that simple can also be special?
One salmon, one venison.
So, are you feeling a little nervous about the chef table in the kitchen tonight for the first time?
If they see a nightmare, they're gonna say, look, this fucking French is fucking crazy.
No, I think they'll be very happy with the fucking nightmare.
With a fully booked ration tonight, and his first diners in the kitchen, Louis should be a very happy man.
Okay, mon ami. Bonne chance. Allez les bleus.
Good evening.
Good evening.
So I hope you're glad to be the first in my kitchen table. I will make a bit of music for you if you want. I can manage this.
We'll never be the best of mates, but we do have one thing in common. Ambition.
Remember what he said, that thing about 12 or 15 things on one plate? So next time you put a dish together and you've gone past 8, 9, 10 things on the plate, mm-hmm. give me a fucking call, because I'm coming back when you get to 11. Okay?
Okay.
Allez les bleus. Bonne chance.
Yeah.
Yes? Good luck tonight, yes?
Yeah.
Because I think you're going to fucking need it. Ciao, ciao. Bonne soirée.
I sincerely hope he makes it a success. Who knows? Maybe the Michelin star will follow.